Right. Now, if I was interested in sending blood from my left ventricle to my right arm, I would start off with the arch of the aorta, which leaves the left ventricle. But I would go immediately into the brachiocephalic trunk, this big artery that only exists on the right side. And because I'm going to the arm, I would go from the brachiocephalic trunk into the right subclavian artery, which goes underneath the clavicle, which is how it gets its name. Once this artery arrives in the area of the axilla or the armpit, I change its name into the axillary artery. It's the same artery as the subclavian artery, but now it has a different name. And I do this again because when this artery leaves the axilla and enters the upper arm, I refer to this artery as the brachial artery. This brachial artery then enters the forearm where it divides and forms the ulnar artery, which goes to the medial side of the hand, and the radial artery, which goes to the lateral side of the hand. So if I was sending blood to the lateral side of the hand, I would go from the brachial artery to the radial artery. But if I was sending it to my little finger instead, I would go from the brachial artery to the ulnar artery.